Patrick Cole. So how are you?
Okay.
Ano ba ang may paglilipot ko sa inyo?
Good afternoon po. I am Maria Zofia Emanuel. I'm from Binilian Press Corps. I'm a new staffer. And we want to thank you for your time for giving us the opportunity to interview you for our
school paper?
Yes.
Okay.
So orient lang po namin kayo on the flow po of what we have. So first po, interview po for our article.
We're gonna have new 3 bridges in Manila. We're gonna build more bridges para more access sa mga pag-area, para option.
So, first question po, just to come up for you, view perspective niyo po. So, what is the general overview po of your life method po, as mentioned po, you have on your Facebook page? What parts it usually covers more on scopes and limitations?
Sa trabaho? What we're trying to do nowadays in the city of Manila is to, at the very least, implement basic things. Basic governance, basic policy, basic law. In this case, ano ba ang mga pangunahin? Kalinisan, kaayusan, kapanatagan, mga naninirahan, at tumarako dito sa lungsod ng Manila. Like you, yung mga estudyante, hindi ko alam kung sino sa inyo taga Manila. But one thing for sure, during daytime, if you're in your school, like in this case, Lazaro, St. Binir, you're inside the city, and we, as people in government, have that kind of obligation to give peace of mind sa damdamin ng inyong mga magulang na kayo ay ligtas at maayos na nag-aaral dito sa lungsod. Basic yun. And we do, we utilize technology as a form of communication to the people. We try to make them participate, make them inform, participate, and cooperate with the city government. Ma-update lang yung taong bayan kung ano nangyayari. Hindi ko isang dagdag na servisyo na yun sa tao. And we will never be perfect or correct in all our undertakings, but we will not take it sitting down because I don't like passive leadership. Yung lalang. Kinikipit balikat na lang ang mga bagay-bagay. Sa paggamit ng teknolohiya, na-open namin ang sarili namin sa direkta sa taong bayan. So now they can inform us to make us efficient. And at the same time, there is a way for you to express your if you appreciate the things. Because if you appreciate things, it inspires us and make us better and efficient government employees and officials.
Next question po, since sinabi nga po there is no perfect methods po in every situation, there are repercussions in everything. So using your current method po of using that, some people po see it as an effective method, while some see it as, sabi na po natin, so, sa inyo po, what is the fine line between transparency and an act of publicity?
Well, publicity, you only say and show good news in favor of a particular person. But in our case, in a live feed, shit's happened. Diba? So, wala siyang pwedeng ikubli. I'll tell you one thing, last night lang, di ba? I've checked streets of Manila. I'm happy in the beginning of the live broadcast. but in the last part of the live broadcast, medyo nainis ako. Bakit? Eh, may basura na naman sa kalye. Diba? Nakita ko eh. So, nakita rin ng taong bayan, anong portion ng pagkukulang ng syudad, ano naman portion ng pagkukulang ng tao. So, fair. Oh, and I don't think that's what you call publicity. We don't do that. We use that as a tool for information ng tao. Because you deserve to know what's happening in your government. Ang maganda lang dito, walang toskas to. Kasi yung load ko lang naman ng ano, ang nagagastos sa yung bandwidth ko. Oh, di ba? But more than anything else, it's worth it because mas magiging efficiente kami pagkasali kayo. The concept of groundswell. Bottom up, involve ng tao para sa pamamaraan. Yeah, I was taught by my professor on how to utilize technology to be efficient. So, makikita ninyo yung kahinaan namin, makikita ninyo saan kami malakas, makikita ninyo saan kami epektibo, makikita nyo rin kung saan kami pagkukunan. Kasi walang pagkukunan.
Next question po, since there is no perfect approach nga po as mentioned, there are advantages and disadvantages po for this type of methods. So tingin niyo po, in terms of your advocacy po, what are those advantages and disadvantages and how does this reflect po the image of your advocacy you aspire to show to Manileños?
Yung advantages, makikita mo kagad if things are being followed, if programs of governance being received. Disadvantages is that you are exposed to so many ideas, complaints, and so on and so on. You will handle it is to know how to discern. And there are also some what we call trolls, wanted to be noticed. Yung kalabang mo lang ba sa kahit na anghel pa ang isang tao sa mata ng kalabaw mo sa politika, demonyo ka. Ganun naman yan. But ako kasi more than anything else, in democracy, 50% plus 1 lang. Dapat kung kami gagawa ng polisiya, programa, ang minimum numbers na makikinabang at least 51%. If we can do it 52, 60, 70, 80, 90%, that's better. We cannot win them all. May ups and downs. But what is important is the intention. What is the purpose of having this? Utilizing this technology. Yun ang importante. More than anything else. Our purpose is to inform you. If you're pleased, thank you. If you're not, then we'll do better. Talagang hirap mag-publish sa live. Ang hirap talaga. Hindi siya madali. Kasi nga, talagang makikita mo. Biglang nagkakagulo, biglang chaotic, biglang maayos. You'll never know talaga. So it's like unedited, unadulterated ba tawag doon? Yung data, information. Fresh.
So given na po yung advantages and disadvantages po na you have mentioned, what made you choose this method po out of all possible choices to portray open governance?
And because that's the first thing that I signed. Open governance. It's high time. Kasi sayang naman. Alam ko mamaya manonood kayo na YouTube. Mamaya magpo-post kayo sa Instagram, sa Twitter niyo, sa Facebook niyo. Bakit hindi ko na lang kayo kausapin bilang pamahalaan? Ilapit ko ang pamahalaan sa inyo. At the tip of your finger. Kaya ako nahuhuli yung mga nagkakating trip. Oh, yung mismong tao ang nakabiktima, o kaya niya iparating sa amin yung ano. I give you an access to us. Oh, yun yan. And with that, oh, hindi ibig sabihin, siyempre araw-araw yan, dami yan, libo. Libo yan, maniwala kang libo. Oh, randomly, oh, we get data, we analyze, we revalidate. If that's a valid data, then we govern.
So, yung ito po kasing approach na to, parang based on my perception po, is tedious din po. Syempre po, marami po siyang workload po kasi kailangan po natin i-handle each and every...
Hindi naman namin lahat nalalive. Kanina, nakita nyo, there are some in-betweens. But most of the things, majority of it is being thrown out to the public eye, exposing ourselves to problems. Kasi hindi naman lahat ang gagawin mo, ikalulugod ng lahat eh. May ilan ding hindi nalulugod sa ginagawa at nakagawa. That's why we try to communicate to us to pay some sacrifices. Kasi, as I always say, don't expect different results will come to you tomorrow. If what you did today is the same as yesterday, that's what Einstein said.
Yun po, given po yung long, yung method na po ba ito is for long term po ba or for short term po?
So far, it's been 4 months now. We've never missed. Well, if I may borrow the analytics of Rappler, I think sabi ng Rappler, we've used almost 10,000 hours already. Kasi PIO naman ang nag-handle eh. Hindi naman ako eh. So I do my work. Sometimes it will that we have to go live because they need to know. But there are things, so kanina yung ambassador may tinatanong sa akin about solving crimes. Hindi ko pwede basa-basa sabihin yung nitty-gritty of it because people are watching. Ikinukob din namin for the simple reason. So not to educate the criminals on how we were going to apprehend them. Diba? At there are times naman, baligtad naman. Sinasabi namin kung nasaan siya. Para sort of say, alam namin kung saan ka pupunta sa susunod. So better be, sumuko ka na lang. Depende sa sitwasyon. But generally, it's more beneficial to the people than to me. Kasi ang nangyayari, dumarami yung trabaho ko. Eh, pero teka, ano ba yung trabaho ko? Public service. Eh, ano ba hinihingi ng tao? Public service. Diba? That's the price you have to pay by utilizing technology and governance.
So sa tingin niyo po, kaya niyo po siya sustain
at the
end of the term or
mag-minimize,
diba?
Kahit araw-araw, kahit minuto. Lalo kung may update, bakit ba hindi? It's either magsawa ka or matuwa ka na talagang school, you have the whole day in your school, wala kang tayo makapanood ng balita, then all you have to do is watch the Capitol report on a Friday. It can be in the morning, it can be in the afternoon, it can be in the evening. Why? So that you will know what happened last Monday, last Tuesday, Wednesday. So, okay, worth it naman pala yung binayad kong buwis. Because you have the right to know on what's going on. You may agree with it, for specific programs or actions. You may disagree with it. Yeah. But what matters most is you were informed. Kung alimbawa ayaw na ng tao manood ng live, o di hinto na kami. But I don't think so that the people would stop watching the live feed, especially kung ang inilalabas namin hindi naman ako. It's about what's going on. Yeah? What's happening. It's just that I'm the one reporting. to the people why I'm doing the mayor. I am obliged to report. So nowadays, hindi mo na kailangan maghintay ng 365 days to listen to a 30-minute speech on what happened in the entire year when what we call city address, state of the city address. Ito, every week may state of the city. At least, paano nang siya, ano nangyayari? Di ba? So, first time in history, almost every week may state of the city. At least, updated ka lang.
Siyempre po, hindi naman po natin naiwasan na yun nga po, since first time lang po ito, parang nakaka-overwhelm po siya sa Manila News at first.
I'm happy for you kung na-overwhelm ka. Kasi it's good for you. Pwede pala. Posible pala. Kaya pala. Ito lang nakaisip. Facebook was with us, what? How many years now? More than a decade? Facebook Live is about 2 years ago. So, just like mayor performance.
Sige nga po, nakaka-overwhelm po siya. So, pagtagal po nun, syempre po, hindi po natin maiwasan na magiging normalized din po itong method na to. And pag-i-increase po yung demand po ng mga tao din po as time comes. So,
and then we'll innovate our approach to make it more entertaining. At the same time, educational. Technology will always be developed. Pipilitin na huwag maging boring. That you're just listening to the rants, the promotion, the problems, the solutions. Baka makaisip din tayo ng ibang mga pamamaraan.
So that is your plan on how to sustain?
We will sustain. I will never get tired. As long as you're happy. Ganun lang kasi, because that's what you call governance. You always make your people happy.
So, moving on po, what are your main goals po during your term, this first term po?
Well, I hope that for the end of the term, Manila is now vibrant again. More green space. Green, open space. More conducive. Economically healthy. Peaceful, orderly. Then I hope by that time we can also come up with vertical development with regard to addressing our problem with healthcare, traffic, tourism, and job generation.
Are there any plans for that Manileños can expect from you that remains unannounced or currently in progress?
May announce, and currently. All of them. May mga asahan pa sila.
Pwede po kayo disclose po each?
Secret. Ganina, napilitan lang ako sabihin kay Ambassador kasi pareho kami nung idea about the possible public transport to ease the effect of people getting hardship in accessing public utility vehicles. We can augment it as a city.
Any plans for running for higher position by the end of the year?
Well, the highest position in the city is mayor. So I think wala na siguro dito. I don't know. I'll just cross the bridge when I get there. But for now, I think I owe it to you as Manilans. I owe it to you. You deserve better days from your city government. So I'll try to focus on that. I don't want to think actions that we're doing is simply because for election or re-election, people already tired of election. Wala na lang choice kasi talaga may election. But I think I would rather focus on making Manila vibrant again.
Do you have any, ano po yung future plans niya after?
Future plans? Ah, magtuturo na ako.
So,
after my term, magtuturo ako, literally. Yeah, that's my retirement plan. I've been working since 10 years old. And I am now his speech, the academic way, the theoretical way, and the practical way. I've been in government for 2 decades. If I can share some simple technique, why not? Because, you know, transferring knowledge and experience, yun ang gusto kong end game ng buhay. Andun na lang ako sa blackboard. Pero sa next generation.
May lumalabas na po kasi mga news every time po ng mga projects na everyone is encouraging you to be the future president. what are your comments po about it? And well, do you have any
thank you. Thank you very much. If you could see that with that way. But I don't want to raise your expectation. Wala pa akong nagagawa sa Manila. I'm just trying to do what is basic. And thank you na, appreciate it. For that thoughts alone, it shows that you appreciate what's going on. For now, I'll just focus on our commitment to the people of Manila. Saka layo pa, no? My God. Di ba kayo napagod na nakaraang halalan? Oh, ako napagod eh. Napaka-uphill ng labang ko eh. But we'll see. For now, let's just all focus. How can we one way or another, a few days thereafter, pack, balik ako, ayan ako. Hindi ko alam, anong difference nung sa iba. I'm just trying to be me and being honest. Nakikita nyo, ito ah, ito pala isa pa. Nakikita nyo, nagagalit ako sa Facebook lang. Nagagalit in such a way, in a very respectful manner. Because when it's wrong, it's wrong. Pansin nyo. Then, I praise people and thank them if they cooperate or help to the policy. So, I'm just being me. No pretensions. You see me laugh. You see me literally laugh out. Ano ang tawag nito? Laugh out loud? Yeah, LOL. Nakita niyo talaga ako. Tumatawa ako. Ay, minsan nagagalit ako. Parang ako si Raul eh. Because of the mood. What type of mood? Kaya ba't nagbabago yung mood? Because nagbabago yung environment. Kanina lang, masaya ka. Ang linis-linis. Napapatupad ang 55-55. Bawal uminom sa kalye. Napapatupad yung curfew. Nawala yung mga bata. Ligtas sila. Tanatag ako. Lumilinis ang kalye. Then all of a sudden, pagliko mo lang ng ibang kanto, kaya mga kaibigan, wag ko kayong dadaan dito ha. Ito ligata, traffic po talaga. You know, bigla ka nalulungkot. But in such a way, you're trying also to inform the very least yung public, oh nga, huwag natin daanan yung Legarda. Kasi nakita natin kay Isko, asama pala talaga ng itsura. Kaya palang traffic doon ngayon. Pero, tas biglang bibigyan mo ng hope. Paano hope? Factual hope. Okay, mag-alala mga kababayan. Nakausap ko
na si Secretary Villar at saka si Regional Director na ito, bibilisan ito. So you give them hope that on a specific period of time, it will be all gone and finished and good for the city and the people of Manila. Then all of a sudden, bigla pa, may tambak ng basura. Pagkalagpas ko, malinis. Oh, nainis ako dito, natuwa ako. So it's just being me. Diba being you is when there's bad things, nag-iiba yung mood mo. And there's good things, nag-iiba rin yung mood mo. Wala siyang pretensions. Ayun ang ayoko kasi, iniiwasan ko yung pretensions. Pag kailangan magalit, kailangan magalit. Kailangan matuwa, kailangan matuwa. Kailangan pasalamatan, kailangan pasalamatan. Kailangan kilalanin, kailangan kilalanin. Ganun lang. I don't know why it became unusual. I don't know. It is really up to the viewers. It is really up to those followers following the vlog. At least I'm not earning from it. I let other individuals who are helping us promoting the city of Manila doing vlogs in their YouTube account. I watch some of them and I'm happy for them because when there's advertisement, may kumita. But in Facebook, you cannot do that. Wala akong official account ng YouTube. Wala. Meron akong Twitter, meron akong Instagram, but we utilize Facebook. Kasi gusto namin across demographics. Tapos, cross-section pa siya.
So, do you have anything po to add for with regards po on your method on the hope po for betterment?
Well, wala naman. I hope they continue to follow the blog and share it to others so that others will be informed also. Sa pili ng movies natin. So far naman, we are reaching about 4 to 7 million people every week. And we only have about 1.8 million. Even pinagpapasalamat ko nga sa mga OFW saka immigrants. Kasi sometimes, naging teleserye, iskoserye na yung tawag, iskoserye ba yun? Pinagpapasalamat ko kasi because of that, ang dami tumutulong. Can you imagine you inspired a 7-year-old boy to give his entire savings? Kasi Aaron, diba? Taga-Kalookan niya. So, we'll continue as long as you like. So we'll try to innovate, but it's getting boring. Or we'll try to make it more, televiewers friendly or entertaining. But the bottom line is our content's purpose is for public information. Nothing more. Incidental lang ako sa content. It's the value of information that we're sending. Thank you.
So we would like to thank you for
my part. Sure. Let's see how many yung pagtinignan mo siya. Post-reach 9.3 million, post-reach 5.7 million. On average. So, we're really trying to reach as many as possible because they deserve to know.
Thank you.
Tara man ako sa DPWH. Ha? Oh. Happy. picture ba?
Yes. 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 Yes.